was giving me some tips over there, so now I have two pages of notes. The gentleman I'm going to introduce you to started his career in 2006 as a territory manager in training in the Pacific Southwest. He was assigned to a territory in the Valley in 2007, made the move to Chicago Loop in 08. So you're probably wondering, why would a guy move from that climate to Chicago? But he knew there was a huge business opportunity there. In 2010, he became the SSDM in the Western Great Lakes area. In 2013, he became a district manager in the Western Great Lakes area. I want to talk a little bit about the body of work for this individual. 2014, he was 104.1% of budget with an 11.4% increase. Had a 0.87 NPR, $668,000 in new business, Rayburn Equipment Food Service, averaged $36,000 food safety, averaged $36,000 per associate. Had a 5.1% no purchase. I think that's a pretty good year, but it wasn't good enough. So he rebuilt the team. He made three additions to the team, changed some people out, and he has spent the bulk of this year just developing that team and pushing them to be better every single day. And he leads by getting in the car with them and showing them the importance of relationships and showing them the importance of understanding their customer and delivering expectations. He sets the pace with the team, whether it's mechanical or whether they're talking about numbers. In my opinion, he embodies what On Your Market means. He knows his customers. He knows the prospects. He has successfully put a formidable competitor in the marketplace, Tunney, on their heels. And the wins that he's experienced this year against them are nothing short of phenomenal and led to the success that he's had in 2015. So that district will finish 2015 at $8.8 million, 107.4% of budget currently, a 12.9% increase, a 1.25 new program ratio, a 1.42 increasing declining ratio, 7% no purchase, $430,000 in Rayburn Equipment and Food Safety Solutions. The team averages $212 in on the shelf. Every territory manager, $212 average. Sales increase this year to date, $817,209, 96.8% of call coverage, delivering value. And the entire team has done it with zero accidents and zero injuries. Whoa. It's my honor to introduce you to the District Manager of the Year for the United States, Mr. Sonny Schotting.
Thank you. I was going to start this speech off with a joke, but it was concerning my height, but I see Mr. John Sherman beat me to St. Louis. But seriously, thank you, Tim. I accept this award with great honor and gratitude. I've been fortunate to have worked with some great district managers throughout my career. Don Baca, Enrique Gamboa, Pat Cullen, Matt Switzke. My time with him has molded me into the district manager I am today, and for that I thank them. But getting to this point, here to this stage, in front of all of you, will not exist if not for a team effort. I'd like to recognize some of those people who came with me who would not have made this possible. First, I want to thank my team, Chicago Loop North District. I truly have the best group of guys I've worked with. We all have very different personalities. There's a second guy named Sonny in my district as well. But somehow we all gel, we work hard, and we have fun doing it. So I appreciate everything those men do on a daily basis. I'd like to thank Matt Marcus, our area manager. Matt brought me into this area early into my career from the PSW as a transfer request submitted by myself. It wasn't as simple as him clicking his approval to accept the transfer. He actually sent his district manager out to work with me for several days before he agreed to take me upon. Thank you, Matt, for giving that opportunity. We will obviously miss you. I want to thank Bonnie Marinucci and the ladies of RFSC, Bruce Feedback, Tim Carey, and our corporate accounts team. Our S&D team who keep everything, the new business flowing. My coworkers and friends, Mike Ignacio and Mike Martin, who I speak to on a daily basis, I thank them for all their support and just hearing the event. Lastly, most importantly, I want to thank my family, my mother, along with my sister, are the ones that raised me into the person I am today. my beautiful wife, Monty, who was always encouraging and supportive, my 2.5-year-old son, Isan, who will tell me occasionally, "Papa, turn off your phone." Sometimes I need those not-so-subtle reminders from him, and I'm blessed to have such loving people and supportive people in my life. Finally, I want to simply just thank Ecolab for being Ecolab. I am forever grateful to be working for such a great company, and I look forward to the next chapter. Thank you.